Hey, it's Azure Friday. We're talking about virtual machines with Corey Sanders. We learned about WA agent deprovisioning stuff.
Yeah.
I recently discovered this, and I blogged about it a little bit, and I think it should be even more obvious because it's such a great feature.
I knew you were going to give me a hard time
Sorry.
About this.
the thing is, though, and I understand why they're separate. There's the gallery,
yeah.
which are official Microsoft prepared created virtual
yep.
machine images.
Yep.
That I can trust. There's
right.
no viruses on those images.
Right. That's right.
They're
That's right.
secure and quality.
They're either created by us or created by a very trusted partner. Right.
right.
Canonical makes the Ubuntu images. Right?
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Right.
All right.
As an example.
Yeah. So down here, though, in the Images tab, and this is where you have to go. You go to Virtual Machines
yeah,
and then Images.
Yeah.
No, that's okay.
Yeah.
Browse VM Depot. These are made by community partners.
Correct. Correct.
But there's a bunch of them.
A ton.
Yeah. It's almost completely out of control.
Yeah. It's a little bit cumbersome,
With
actually.
All due respect.
No, no. I mean, it's kind of in some ways when this kind of blew up, we sort of said, I guess it's a good problem to have. But yeah. You kind of have to know what you're looking for.
Yes.
There's so many things.
But check this out. This blew me away. Look at that. Hardened Redis server. Now, here's the thing, though. I need to know that partner and that publisher.
You got to trust them.
And trust them. And
right.
I know what did they harden
and,
it
And
the
we do
right
have
way.
The rating system here. But, you know, obviously, with so many images in here, you've got one person who said good.
Yeah, yeah. but I could go and say, I think there's GitLab.
There was a GitLab. You passed it.
Yeah. There was a Discourse.
Django.
This Discourse
yep.
is the... Jeff Atwood's new Ruby-based
That's right.
thing.
And
so
this was Bitnami, right?
Bitnami,
so that's
these guys are
partner.
Very cool.
Yep.
Bitnami has a bunch of these.
They're great.
And one of the things
They've
that I thought was cool
with.
Is that I can go up and look for VM, what is it called? Like VM Depot, I think it's called?
Yeah, VM Depot, that's right.
Depot.
It's by Microsoft OpenTech.
Okay.
Yeah.
There we go. VMDepot.msopentech. And I could say, find one. Let's look for, say, I don't know, Redis, whatever.
Yeah.
And then that's going to go and search the image. Same way, same exact gallery. But what's cool about this, we'll do Discourse because they use Redis. Hit deployment script, pick a region. They actually write the command
cool.
line.
Yep,
and this
exactly.
is actually how I learned how to do the web farm that I did before.
Oh, fantastic.
Because look.
It creates the endpoint for you.
Yeah, it
how
creates
cool
a load balance endpoint for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, exactly right.
You just pass in the DNX prefix.
Exactly right.
That is the image name, and this speaks to the very first video where you and I were talking.
Yes.
They must have a storage account somewhere.
Yes.
Full of these things.
That's right. That's right.
I'm
That's
guessing.
Right.
But
That's
that...
right. That's right. Exactly right. And I think, you know, that's one of the reasons why today this is a little bit more cumbersome of a process than the gallery images that we've got.
Yeah.
Is because they manage that storage account versus our replication system.
So if I go into Notepad and we'll say, make the Corey forum. And we'll put in
the
nod there. And password. That's my password, by the way. Super, super hard password.
There you go.
Make sure we turn on SSH. I can take this command here, and I'm using, again, the cross-platform tools.
I love those things.
They're great.
Yep.
Go like this. So looking up community image. I'm assuming then it's looking up their storage account and then
Correct.
Copying it into my blog.
That's right. That's exactly
And then
right.
they'll boot it up
And
again.
Then they'll insert that as an image. So the key thing is that they're copying it into your account and then they'll insert it into it as an image into your account.
Mm-hmm.
So the next time you go into your account, you'll see this image as one of the options for you to redeploy multiple times. So you don't have to do this more than once. Right? So this is kind of a very interesting point.
Okay.
Let's see if it actually pops
it's
in.
It's interesting because it makes me wonder if I go into virtual machines right now, will I see it being made as it's being made. Because it says, this is looking it up, creating VM. So I'll go in here. I'm just going to restart the portal. And there's Corey Forum. Okay,
there you
check
go.
That out. So that's actually coming up. And let's go and see. Now this is provisioning, right? So it's still starting up, so the buttons haven't lit up yet.
Oh,
there you go.
There you go.
Oh, okay. See, they actually
delete
it.
Oh, they delete the image.
They
okay.
delete it because they don't want you to pay twice.
Yeah, okay.
But you're right, though. I think there's a way to prevent
To make it so that they stop, don't delete it. Yeah,
copy the image over and then make it available. So then in a minute here, I'll have my own forums or your own forums.
Yeah.
So I thought that was really, really
That's
cool.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love that. Yeah, I really like the VM Depot capability. And you can actually go in and upload your own. So anyone can go upload into this and it'll appear.
So it really is a web of trust, though.
I mean,
someone could put up an evil one.
They could.
And we'd take it down eventually. But
yeah.
You have to know who you're trusting.
Exactly. It's all about who the provider is that you trust. Yeah. But yeah, we wanted to make sure that it was very open.
Yeah, I think about it like NuGet and NPM and gems.
Exactly.
It's community offered stuff.
Right.
But know your publishers.
That's right. That's right. Exactly right.
Very cool. It's Azure Friday. Thank you.